Oftentimes with supplements, you'll see a standard expiration date of 1 year or 2 years out in the future from whenever it's made. I wanted to take an opportunity to talk about shelf life of herbs. This isn't an easy, like, here's the direct answer, because it depends on a bunch of factors. It depends on the herbs we're talking about, and then it depends largely on factors that you control in how you store the herbs. First, it's important to note that there really isn't like a bad expiration where this product is gonna begin to hurt you if it goes past a certain date. This isn't milk sitting in your fridge or sitting outside of your fridge, right? But even there, that's kind of iffy thing, like milk turning at a certain stage, you get buttermilk, and some people really like that, right? So even there, there's not a clearly defined boundary. Oftentimes with supplements, people will use a standard 1 year or 2 year expiration date from whenever the product is manufactured, which can be kind of interesting because that is maybe when it's finally put together and put in capsules, but how long was the herb in extract form before that? So it's really kind of iffy in that. And as I said, it depends on a lot of factors. So the first thing I want to talk about is the different jars and containers. What causes an herb to not go bad, but lose its potency, because that's what is going to happen. It is exposure to light, exposure to air, and exposure to moisture. Those are the three things that can cause issues with the herbs. And those are the only three things. Time itself really isn't a factor in so much by itself, but when you have more time for light, air, or moisture to get at those different herbs. Of those, moisture is really kind of probably the worst thing. You get moisture in there, it can really turn the herb. But the things that are generally going to do it, because it's relatively easy to keep moisture out of the herbs, is light and air. You'll see I have a variety of jars here. In a normal glass like this, all the light is just passing through. It's clear glass. So you can get things like, this just happens to be a bluish, greenish tinged glass. Keep the pine pollen here because I tend to go through it quickly. Not a huge deal. You compare that to Myron glass. This is violet glass. It looks black. Most of the light is just being refracted, bounced off of this. It's not getting into it. Only the violet spectrum really gets into the glass. And there's some ideas that it may actually charge and enhance the thing in there. But at the very least, what it's doing is blocking most of the light, so it keeps the things much fresher. You'll notice we use amber glass with all of our tinctures. And tinctures just being an alcohol extract, these things last basically forever. They're really not going to lose much potency, especially in the amber glass, maybe a little bit if they were in clear glass, but you'll notice that pretty much no one uses clear glass for tinctures. So Myron glass really is the best thing to help with the light factor in preserving your herbs with that. But there can be an issue with it is in that these aren't vacuum sealed, so air can get in there depending on how much of the herb is in there. You never want to leave your herbs out just exposed to the air like this. That is a way for them to lose potency real quick. So having some sort of lid, there is going to be air in there, but it's not too much. And once again, it depends on the herb. So in this one, I happen to have Tongkat Ali. And this is not something that I've been taking a whole lot recently. So this bag's kind of old. We do provide an oxygen absorber in the bag, which helps with it. However, it's not everything. You probably can't see there, but there's a little bit of clumping that has occurred with this. So this Tongkat Ali is a bit oxidized. And one thing we notice with Tongkat Ali is that its potency does seem to go away once it is oxidized. It can still have some effect, but it doesn't seem to work nearly as well as a fresh stuff that has its full potency with it. So like I said, I can use this, but it's really not the best Tongkat to be using right there. Now, you contrast that to some other herbs like our shilajit resin. Shilajit coming from the Himalayan mountains, literally oozing out of the ground. This stuff has been around, been active in the world for hundreds, if not thousands of years. In essence, this stuff is immortal. Now, it can get dried out if you expose it to air. It's not that it loses its potency there, just maybe harder to work with in that form. But there are some ways you can work with that. If you use like a double boiler system, you can sometimes get it to liquefy back down. But like I said, it's still good in that form. It just turns into a rock, a little bit harder to work with. So the last thing I want to cover is what we found in our warehouse, what my brother called a time capsule. For those of you that have been with us a long time, you may notice our old name and logo here, Superman Herbs. For those of you that haven't been with us long, that was our name before we were forced to change it by DC Comics. So what we found was this bag of reishi and this bag of cordyceps. Notice this is in its outer mylar bag. This has been opened and does not have that outer mylar bag with it. You'll notice that there are big chunks here. This has been oxidized. In fact, it is mostly chunky right here, and I'll give you a close-up of this. Meanwhile, the mylar bag, notice the black, this is refracting the light off of it, so it's not getting inside, and this has not been opened at all. This stuff is over 2 years old, so it's pretty old. Generally would not be recommended to have it, but if we look at this reishi, really quite interesting that this seems perfectly fine, good to go in this form. It is completely powdered down. It has not hardened at all like the Cordyceps militaris here has. It smells good. If I tasted it, it would taste just as good as the other reishi. It's probably lost a little bit of potency, but I'd say this is completely fine to go despite being over 2 years old. However, if I open up this package, I leave it out, not in this protective mylar bag, then it's going to begin to lose potency. It will turn into something like that over time. Now, mylar and plastic bag, not the best stuff to be storing herbs in. We are searching for a way to get around this and use more sustainable packaging, also something that doesn't involve plastic at all. But it's difficult because there's a trade-off between this, which not only is easy to ship and quite cheap, but it does protect the herbs quite well. If we shipped herbs to you in cardboard, light would be getting in, moisture would be getting in, and air definitely is getting in there as well. So it doesn't have that same protective quality to it that these mylar bags happen to have. So I covered a lot of information, but hopefully this answers all your questions about shelf life with the herbs. Let me also address, what should you do when you get the herbs? Well, if you're not going to use them right away, keep them in the bag here. That can be a great way to go. Or as soon as you get it, and you, if you have these available, transfer the herb over into mylar glass or whatever type of glass you have. Even if you only have clear glass, store this in a cabinet like this where it doesn't get a lot of light at all, and it's going to be fine just like that. Then, of course, consume your herbs in a regular manner. That's going to reduce down the amount of oxygen getting to them, light, anything getting to them, so that they keep their potency.